In this video, I'm going to show you how to diagnose a P0014 and a P0015 for the variable valve timing solenoid or vanose solenoid on a BMW. Also show you where these valves are located and how you can clean the variable valve timing solenoid or vanose solenoid on these BMWs and how to test it.
Alright, got a BMW X3 here with a check engine light on, we're diagnosing. I just got my little, I just wanted to do a quick kind of review on this little code reader, pocket code reader I got here. It does BMW as well, so I'm just going to read the codes in this real quick. I use this instead of the bigger scan tools a lot of times just to check and clear codes, just because how fast it is and yeah, it just speeds things up a lot rather than getting the big old bulky tools out. I'm still going to end up hooking the AutoLogic up to this BMW just to make sure there's nothing else that we're missing here for the customer. But for the people at home, this little handheld scan tool is pretty awesome and it's cheap. I'll leave a link in the video description below where you can find this. So it says we got one code. Okay, on this one we got a P0015, which is the exhaust variable valve timing solenoid on this BMW. So I'll probably hook the AutoLogic up to it and do some functionality test, you know, activate the solenoid, make sure it's working. But a lot of times in a case like this, it's going to be oil related. Either they haven't had their oil changed in a while, or the oil's low, or just lack of maintenance, you know, sludgy oil. So I'm going to go ahead and pull this variable valve timing solenoid out and check the condition of it. Put power and ground to it, make sure it's working properly. We're going to check the oil. We're going to change oil if needed. Like I said, I'll probably hook the AutoLogic up to it too and do some bi-directional controls to make sure that solenoid valve is working properly. But and to erase this code, all we would need to do is just hold this and hold it again. And now the codes in this BMW are all erased. Let's go out here and I'll show you where that variable valve timing solenoid is.
It's kind of hard to see here, but at the end of the video I'll show you me installing it. But you have two variable valve timing control solenoids here, right in the front of the motor. Okay, so I went ahead and removed the exhaust variable valve timing solenoid on this BMW. And I'm just going to bench test it. And I'm going to do that with my power probe. I'll also leave a link to that in the description below. Basically, I'm just going to apply power and ground to this solenoid and make sure it's actuating. I don't know if you can see it in the video there, but this valve is actually moving back and forth. And all I'm doing is hooking, I have my power probe hooked to the battery, and I got a power and ground supplied to this. This is just a 12-volt solenoid that you should have continuity through. And when you apply power and ground to it, you should be able to hear a click along with, I see it moving. So this valve here seems to be functioning properly, so what I'm just going to do is clean it out with some brake clean, and then I'll probably blow a little air through this after, but typically, if you remove this in a test well and you clean it up, you can just reinstall it, and if your oil is in good condition, you shouldn't have any further issues. But yeah, I'm just going to reinstall this back into the front of the motor here. I wanted to get a little video clip of that so you have a better idea of where this is located. It is relatively easy to get out. You don't have to take a whole lot apart. There's just one 10mm bolt that's a little tricky to get to. Thanks for watching my video on a P0015 variable valve timing on a BMW. Be sure to hit the thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thanks, Flat Rate Mechanic.